Hello there, Marshall here from Limited Resources, doing another draft with you here on channelfireball.com. And I am in Australia still covering the GP and the Pro Tour for Eldritch Moon. It's out just freshly on Magic Online. And I thought I'd invite my friend and Pro Tour historian, Brian David Marshall, on to hang out and do a little draft. This is a coverage mainstay for us, for you and I drafting together. What do you like out of this pack, Studio?
I love Ruthless Disposal. Yeah. It's the most powerful card I'm looking there. I like Backwoods Survivalist and Bloodbriar just as like cards.
Yeah, you know, it's interesting. I think that the card that we could wheel here that we'd be the best is actually a Bloodbriar.
You think we can wheel that?
I do. I definitely think that it has a good chance to wheel. I mean, if it doesn't, I wouldn't be shocked. Yeah, don't get me wrong. But like, you know, this pack is like not very strong. There's a Sigardian Priest is probably the other good card.
Oh yeah, Sigardian. I didn't even see the priest down there.
Yeah. Mill Giant. Anyway, I'll take the Ruthless Disposal.
Mill Giant's awesome.
Yeah, he's great. All right, what do we got here? Well, there's a Wretched Griff. I like that a lot. Borrowed Malevolence would go in the deck because it's black, but not super high power level. There's a Choking Restraint, which has been properly strong.
Best white common?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so. I think it's better than the Priest. Dusk Feaster's been fine, too. I'm not super excited about it, though.
You're not going to take the Lunark Mantle here?
The what?
The Lunark Mantle?
No. So what's
Marshall's pet card for this set?
I don't even see it. Like, it doesn't even show up for me. So I like Choking Restraints or Wretched Griff, I think.
I like Choking Restraints, and I really enjoy being white-black in this format quite
a bit. Well, let's do it. So we have two premium removal spells to start, which is nice. Ooh, Haunted Dead.
Yeah, Haunted Dead is great. I know you don't care for Campaign of Vengeance.
Not at all.
But if you ended up with a couple Haunted Dead, you might change your mind.
Yes. Yeah. So, you know.
Or if that Spectral Reserves from the last pack wheeled around.
There you go. Yeah, Steadfast Cathar would be any of these. The Midnight Scavengers. You dig that card?
I love that card.
Yeah, just grave digging.
I never get a Graf Rats back anymore. I just get like a.
You just get real cards.
I just get like an Ironclad Sentry back.
Ooh, Abundant Maw.
Certain Death, which is just. Wow, that's our second Mercurial Geist that's gone by.
Wow, I know. Thankfully, we can kill those. Extricator of Sin is better than I thought it was originally, though I'm still not. You know, it doesn't draw me to it. I'm not like, ooh, Extricate. But it does make the cut more than I thought it would. I like taking Certain Death or Abundant Maw here. What do you dig?
I mean, I like the certainty of Certain Death.
Let's just do it. Creatures are for the weak.
Now Eat the Heart. Swarm is green.
Yeah, there's a Graf Rats. I think the Ingenious Scob's the best card here.
Right, we're not locked into being white at
not
all.
Not at all. We could just take it. We could also take green. We could take It of the Horrid Swarm.
That might feels like that's the best card in the pack.
Yeah, it's one of these two. It's probably Ingenious Scob. I'm going to take the It. I think I'd rather be... Well, you know what? It's black-blue a thing. I think green-black's probably better, right? Do you have any sense for that?
I think black green certainly like what I want to be doing when I play Magic.
All right, well, let's do that.
You know,
that's good enough for me.
Graveyard Shenanigans. There's another It of the Hard Swarm. There's a Terrarian. That's a card that's gone up for a lot of people
for sure. Unsubstantiated. I like Borrowed Malevolence here though. Like, look, we're going to be black, right? I mean, at this point, I mean, it's not 100%, but we're like 90% to be black. And we might be white, we might be green, but we can just take another black card and sort of stay on course here. I think that's good for us.
I mean, Terrarian, though, also lets us...
It does let us
still explore the idea of being three colors.
It does. Yeah, let's just take this. We'll see if anything pushes.
Just really good. I like Gavinny Unhallowed. There's an Ironclad Slayer, though. I mean, we don't have anything to return with it. Well, other than Choking Restraints.
It's a little slow.
Which is kind of a slow loop to get into, but... Not unreasonable. I think I love Ironclad Slayer. And if we pick up like any dead weights or a Boon of Emrakul in the next pack.
It's nice having it now. This is our seventh pick, so there's only one unknown card here out of this. One unknown pack, I should say. But we've got all of pack two. And like you said, dead weights, Boon of Emrakul, more Choking Restraints can be really good.
This basically looks like 90% of the decks I've drafted in this format so far.
Do you like Weirded Vampire here?
I mean, it's... fine. I think I prefer it of the hard swarm here.
Number two.
Yeah.
It's just like, are we really going to be green at this point?
I don't think so. I don't know. I'll just take the weirded vampire.
I'll just take a. I was calling it solid. Doesn't quite feel accurate. Wow, mockery of nature. Let's see, backwards survivalist. Maybe I'll just take this. I mean, there's still a chance that these, would you rather have Backwood Survivalist and It of the Horde Swarm or Ironclad Slayer and Choking Restraint?
Well, I think you know my answer.
Yeah, it's this one, right? But
you might not get you. We haven't seen a ton of white cards.
That is very true. Oh no, the Lunar.
Oh no.
We'll just take this.
On principle,
we'll just look the other way. Sure.
Yeah, Thraben Foul Bloods is just.
This card's been a little better than I thought. It's weird because I recognize
Seth Manfield really.
Yeah, he loves it.
At the Grand Prix.
Yeah.
It's hard to argue with Seth.
It is funny. I recognized early in the form, like pre-release, I noticed that there's a lot of one toughness creatures, mainly because I had a Smoldering Werewolf, and I noted just to myself like how good it performed. I was like, wow, or how well it performed. I was like, wow, and. I think that I didn't properly adjust for Make Mischief being on that same. It's like it still kills the same stuff that the Smoldering right. Werewolf does, and the devil's a real thing.
The devil can be a real pain to deal with. You know, you're trying to just this sort of persistent threat of going to get in for point, or I'm going to be able to kill one of your utility creatures.
Totally.
Like your
looks like green is more open here, by the way, like just on number of cards.
Yeah. Just clicking away the white cards here.
No, I'm just gonna pile them up over here, and we'll see.
Ooh, oh boy! Can we switch? Is it too late?
It is.
There's a Mourn Willow for our black green.
Yeah.
I mean, not a super.
Have you been impressed by it? I'm just like.
I mean, I want it to be good.
Yeah, I do too.
I haven't actually played with it yet, so I can't.
I have. It's fine. Like you're not cutting it from a green black deck, but it's just like. Why are you here? Like, why are you two toughness with haste? Like, look at these decks. It's like, you know, we're playing these cards. Like, we're not trying to bum rush somebody.
I mean, do you want to it again?
Could.
Get it,
Markov then. Crusader's been pretty impressive to me. It's not like mind blowing, but it's good. Bedlam Reveler's good.
There's also a drag under there. You know,
I don't want to be these colors. All right, I'm going to take this guy.
Taking the Crusader?
Yeah, I'm going to take the Crusader.
There's another certain... Oh, look what it is, Marshall. Look what it is.
I want you, buddy.
Oh, you want the... Okay.
Yeah.
But do you want it more than you want your Ulvenwald captive?
What? Where? Oh, hello.
That's what I was talking about.
I hadn't made it there yet. I was stuck on Dramyard Behemoth. There's also another certain death. I think that probably this Ulvenwald captive is more important for us at this point than the certain death number two.
Yeah, well, absolutely. Since we have a certain death that we might be able to want to cast on turn
yeah.
five.
Also, we have 0/2 drops.
Yeah.
All right. This isn't bad.
Yeah. We got an Ulvenwald captive.
Card,
I know. You are
so good.
That is your pet card.
Yeah, it really has. It's just a card that, like, I played against, you know, three matches, and I was like, with a bullet, number one best common green.
There's another Bard Malevolence. How about Prey Upon? How do you...
I think it's just slightly worse than Ulvenwald Captive, and I think it's good in this deck. Yeah, let's just take it. Rise from the Grave, fine.
It's fine. Graph Rats isn't what we're doing.
Here's the best card in the pack.
Yeah. Now, again, I mean, you know, it is... I've seen people say that this is a format... It's just the second Ruthless as well.
The second one is a lot worse than the first, but, you know...
But you draw the first one a lot more often when you have two of them.
Damn right you do.
The second one makes that first one so much better.
We ran the numbers. Yeah, I'm into it. Yeah, I actually want more werewolves now.
Sure.
You know, of any of these new ones...
The werewolf horrors.
Yes, exactly. I think that those are some of the best cards in the set, too.
Well, there's another Ulvenwald captive for you.
Okay, there's also a Foul Emissary.
Which we really like.
We like it. I am just going to take the captive, though. I know that that's a little bit of a little conservative.
Yeah, well,
pick,
we only
I'm
have
just really worried about our curve right now.
Yeah, and we only have the one card right now to that has a merge.
Yeah.
So I would rather have the captive.
Yeah, that's a good point. I mean, even if it replaces itself, that guy, if you're not emerging, it's kind of replacement level. But
yeah, I mean, again,
captive's just great.
And we've just got great cards at 5 and 6 here.
Mm-hmm.
And kind of nothing here.
We bricked. Yeah, just straight up nothing. Wow. That's bad. Jeez, another one of those?
Another Foul Blood. I like Grapple with the Past.
Me too.
I like it better than Cemetery Recruitment in this deck right now.
Definitely. This deck's kind of sweet.
What are we looking for in the third pack?
What are we looking for? More removal would be good. Sort of as a matter of course. What else would we like? I don't know.
Some werewolves.
Some bombs.
So there's a Wolfkin Bond. There's a Hamlet Captain for a 2-drop. Wolfkin Bond. How many creatures do we have? Like 10?
We've already got 10.
How do you feel about Bond?
I think it's medium.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's powerful. It's a little risky, but, like, it gives you a wolf, so, like, worst-case scenario, it's not that bad. Hamlet Captain, we've got a couple of humans, but not much. We're not really triggering it. It's mainly just a 2-2, just a bear. I'll take it, though. I think the curve consideration is probably worth it. Like, our top end is already decent, and we'll probably pick up another couple of cards before the draft's done. We don't really need much more. This guy's great.
Oh, God, that card is so good.
Yeah, they pushed that one.
We really like discarding cards in our deck.
Yeah, you know, maybe that's the answer, by the way, to what you asked before about what do we want in the last pack. Maybe just a bunch of Delirium stuff. All right, well, we got the Mournwillow back or another It. I guess we just take the Mournwillow.
Sure. I mean, we only have the 2/3s right now.
Yeah.
We kind of can go to 4 pretty easily. How do you feel about Crop Sigil?
I don't like it. Though, I will say that the
gets us 2 cards back. We have a lot of things that we want to pitch cards to.
I do think I'm going to take it here. So I think we're going to end up being a Delirium deck. And if you are dedicated Delirium, you can run a Crop Sigil. I don't like running 2, but the problem that I have with everything came back?
Wow, that's a tough call.
We never ended up with the other half of a Graf Rats. I don't think we want that.
No.
Rise from the Grave or Woodland Patrol?
I kind of like Rise from the Grave.
All right.
We can kill so many things on our opponent's side of the table. Great point. And just rise them. Like, we can kill anything with a Ruthless Disposal.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, totally. Or anythings.
Anythings, yeah.
Yeah, we'll have choices.
Have you talked about your Ruthless Disposal trick?
No, I haven't, and that's one I actually have to talk about on the podcast too, because I didn't know that the rules work that way, but we can talk about it on here. So basically the deal is that you can target, so I was under the impression, so it needs 2 targets, like, right. that is true, you do have to have 2 targets. So there's sometimes where you have 1 creature, they have 1 creature, but their creature must die, like you got to get rid of it. Ooh, Triskaidek Phobia. I hate that card.
I won with that card last night for the first time. Tim didn't block, went to 14. I played Triskaidek Phobia.
And shipped
and
it.
And then he conceded.
That's amazing. All right, so here's Vessel, Lamholt Pacifist.
Boy, I think I like Lamholt Pacifist here.
Okay.
Okay. I mean, Vessel's...
It's great. So here's the difference. Like, Vessel compared to Crop Sigil, to me, this is not remotely close.
You like Vessel much better.
Way better, yeah. And, like, we already have Grapple as well, you know. But I kind of agree, though. I think that Lamholt Pacifist is probably just too powerful.
Plus, there's like, we have the opportunity to pass and, like, activate.
Ooh!
Our werewolf. What do we get here?
Silver for Partisan.
Oh, my gosh.
Look at this pack. There's a Hinterland Logger here and a Dire Swine, which would maybe make the cut. Whatever. Arf. I'm into that. Okay, there's a Vessel.
Intrepid Provisioner is not going to really... Yeah. Not going to have a lot of benefit from that. I don't think
so, yeah.
We're not really getting much of the Delirium that we were looking at. I mean, unless you get a Stallion.
Oh, no. Is that where we're at? Oh, anyway, before I should mention before. So you can target the creature you're going to sacrifice as one of the targets, which I didn't know. I thought that the creature would already be gone. But
right. As long as one of the original targets is still in play when it resolves, mm-hmm. the card tries to resolve as fully as possible.
Exactly.
Are we going to be able to find an epitaph golem?
It's so funny you said that. I just thought of that myself. I just thought that same thing. I was like, oh, just the once. So Twins of Mauer Estate, Skeleton, or Aim High?
I mean, Aim High is the best card there.
I think you're right.
I really like Skeleton in this deck. Skeleton.
Do we have a discard outlets? We're going to splash it into our yard. I mean,
we have the disposals. We have, you know, it just gives us the opportunity to, it's also a creature that we can sack to the disposal.
Yeah, you're right. With two disposals, it's probably going to hold its own. And maybe it doesn't make the cut.
And we also have the Haunted Dead.
Yes. Which doesn't mind being in the graveyard one little bit. And we can loop it.
Anything we want to hate here?
Yeah, I mean, we could take a root out for the board, but that card comes in so infrequently. Otherwise, I would probably take Dance with Devils. I think that's the most annoying of the cards. It could be reduced to ashes, but...
Yeah, I would probably take Reduced to Ashes out, but...
All right.
I'm just, you know, thinking about my Haunted Dead. Oh, a little Groundskeeper action.
Yeah. We kind of miss on the big payoff. Wow, here's our
Delirium reward.
But honestly, I think Byway Couriers is better.
Yeah.
Like, sad. We have to ship the Termagoy for the Byway Courier here. Oh, we have this.
Yeah.
You know, it's interesting because out of Eldritch Moon, this is what the payoffs look like now.
We have so many vessels.
Oh, my God. Man, if we had
one epitaph golem, we could be like...
We have multiple ways to get it back, too. We have Grapple with the Past, and we have two Cemetery Recruitments. Like, because you know how the problem is you mill your epitaph golem?
Yeah, yeah. Let's get that Dire Spawn.
Oh, there we go. That's sweet. I like that a lot.
In for a penny. Yeah. In for a pound.
Yeah. This is what a lot of the Delirium payoffs look like now. Like, oh, your creature gets a little bigger and gets a bonus or gets an extra ability. You know, it's not quite the, like, I have Delirium engage, you know. It's like, oh, everything's a little bigger.
I mean, Dire Swine is
pretty, hits
pretty hard. And if we have the ability to ever bring it back.
Big pig. Man, Triscuit Echophobia. So on videos here on Channel Fireball... I lost to my own Triscuit Decaphobia multiple times.
How did you do that?
So I played it against, and people that watch my videos will be laughing right now, by the way, that I have to tell you this story. So I played it with a similar setup to what you had. Like, it was a good spot. I think I was like a turn or two away from, and they didn't have, you know, pressure on me. I was just going to get them. And they madnessed out Avacyn's Judgment.
Oh, God.
Which you can do to any number of creatures and or players. So they can lower their own life total or mine accordingly to get them out of range and set me up perfectly. Out. Oh, yeah. It was so brutal. And they did it to me in back-to-back games. And that was one draft that I lost due to that card of my own. And the previous time that I tried playing it, I also lost to it on my own. So I have sworn off Triscuit Decaphobia.
I like that you're assuming that I don't watch your videos and I didn't want to just hear you tell that story.
I am assuming that. Are we running Groundskeeper?
Let's see.
By the way, this is very disconcerting. I don't know if you've seen that. You get your cards right.
Oh, yeah.
But like those of us that have been playing Magic Online for years, that also signals the end of the draft.
I'm like, what happened? Did I get dropped?
I'm like, no. But then it's just like, oh, I have cards. Sweet. I took out all of the vessels. I could put them in. We need to still make three cuts from this. We ended up being like not Turbo Delirium. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I don't mind. Like, we have Grapple, and I'll put one in if we think it's good. I think Hamlet Captain can probably go.
I want to fight for Groundskeeper here.
Okay. I'm in for Groundskeeper.
I've actually heard multiple people say that Groundskeeper has gotten a lot better. Usually they're playing with the Spell Shapers.
The what?
This one. Spell shapers were like Waterfront Bouncer was a spell shaper.
Oh, okay. Like tap.
Anything that lets you tap, discard a card to do an effect. So like, what is it? Thraben Standard Bearer in this set. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So like Groundskeeper, Thraben Standard Bearer is like apparently a very real thing to do.
Okay. How much mana would that take? So Groundskeeper, so it's 4 mana to make a 1/1.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you can just keep doing it.
Yeah.
Like once per turn. Yeah. That's pretty good.
You know, or if you have like a Skier's Dag Supplicant mm-hmm. and you're ahead, you can just sort of run that and not go down a card and be able to, you know, sort of accelerate the clock of the game.
What about the Skeleton?
Which one do you like better? I mean, I think we're going to only run one of the two, right?
Okay, yeah.
Which one do you like better? I think I like the Skeleton better. It's more expensive, though.
I think we like the Skeleton better. For, you know, mainly because of the two Ruthless Disposal, like you convinced me on that with the fact that we can discard it or, you know, in a pinch, sacrifice it, you know, like either way. Like it works on both sides of that card. And I think that, you know, we are sort of trying to put our game plan around Ruthless Disposal. I think I like Grapple better than Vessel, but I might be wrong about that. And we do have... Let's take a quick look here at how many cards we have that care about Delirium. Because we do have a, you know, 3 or 4 or something like that, I think. This one does, although does it really, I think, is the question. So these are all of our Delirium cards. We have 5 that actually care about it. You know, none of them are groundbreaking payoffs, but...
So the thing that I like about Grapple... over Vessel is that Grapple can be a pseudo combat trick.
It's a late game. It's so much better.
Right.
Like I had a scenario where I had 12 cards in my graveyard in a late game spot, and I had a Grapple, and I also had a Vessel, and I drew the Vessel, and I thought if that was Grapple, I would have won. Like I would have got my bomb back, and I could choose from 12 cards, or you know, call 10 of the 12 cards that I could buy back. And with Vessel, it's like, well, here's 4. Hope you hit, you know, because you know you need something big or whatever at that moment. And I love it. Yeah, instant speed.
Too. I just love the idea of someone putting like a Inner the Heart Swarm token in front of a Kessick Dire Swine and. You just grapple, and you know, you're almost certainly putting 2 card types into the yard.
Yeah, oh yeah, totally. All right, so here's our deck. It looks sweet.
I like, how many, where did we end up with creature-wise?
16.
That's a lot.
Yeah, plenty of creatures. We're going to be pretty proactive here probably, and then use our removal to get through. All right, so that's our deck. Let's submit and see what it can do.